If you're looking for someone to grind for you in NBA 2K21, then just visit RoseNBA on Twitter for safest, fastest, and most legit grinding services. Link is in the description. Hello everyone, it's PC Elber here. In this video, we'll be talking about how you can get this much shooting badge points after every game in your My Career game mode, which can help you to upgrade 2-3 shooting badges after every game. The main problem with all the other methods available on YouTube is that they work great till the halftime, but after halftime, either we cannot convert because of double team, or our player is too tired and is unable to convert shots. But this method is both double team proof and fatigue proof. To make it fatigue proof, we have to apply a glitch after halftime, so just stick to the end of this video and hit that like and subscribe button now, as I have put lots of effort in figuring out this method. So before starting out with this video, I want to thank you all, as my channel recently completed 8k subscribers and it means a lot to me. And if you haven't subscribed yet, then please do the honor now, as I made regular content for the game NBA 2K20 and I have been doing the same for 2K21 too. And soon we'll be having some pretty cool giveaways, so just subscribe now to never miss events like that. And I've already made a video on the best method to get MT in NBA 2K21 my team. I made 3 videos on VC glitches, 1 video on badge glitch, and I post regular videos on locker codes too. You can watch all these videos by clicking on the links provided in the description, and now let's get started without any further ado. So first of all, we have to make some quick changes. So go to code settings in My Career game mode and change play vision display to full and play calling messages to user plays only. Once you have done that, then go back to your settings and make sure that the quarter length is on 12 minutes and game difficulty is set to pro. Once you have done that, now you're good to go with this method. So now you just have to start any NBA match against the CPU and you have to perform one play again and again. So when your player is not having the ball in his hand, what you have to do is you just have to press the left trigger on your controller, then you'll get an off-ball screen, then you just have to follow the set of instructions as shown on your screen and just make a shot. So now I'll show you the same play again in slow motion to clarify what you have to do. So as you can see, you just have to press the left trigger to get off-ball screen, and now you have to follow the path as represented on screen and ask for a pass. And here I was free and I made a shot, and this will convert into a 3-pointer or 2-pointer, whichever you'll take, every time you try it. So you just have to perform this again and again. So I'll give you some other examples of the same play. So sometimes what will happen is the defender will go under or over the screen and you won't be free for a shot. So what you have to do is, I'll show you that in this clip only. So as you can see, the defender just followed me by going over the screen. So I just went over to the same position and asked for screen, and this time the screen was efficient. And again, even if I didn't green the shot, as you can see, it was slightly late or early, then also my player converted the shot. Now here's another example. As you can see on your screen again, I again asked for screen by pressing the left trigger, and again the defender followed me, so I went over to the same position and asked for screen again, and this time the screen was efficient. As you can see, my player was free for the shot and I made it. And you just have to repeat this play. I'll show you again. As you can see, my player is not having the ball. I'll go there and ask for off-ball screen by pressing the left trigger. I'll have a set of instruction on my screen. I follow the instruction, my player is free, and I made the shot again. I'll again show you a bit different example in the next clip. As you can see, this time the path is different. I asked for screen, but I followed a different path, but the result was same. As you can see, this was a different play. But yeah, for this also, you just have to press the left trigger. It depends on at what position your teammates are. So the play changes from the position of your screen. So this time my player was here, so I asked for screen and I was again free for a three-pointer. So while performing this play, corner specialist badge is really helpful. And as you can again see, I asked for screen, I went there, I got the screen, and I again made the shot. So this works every single time. It worked for my player, it will work for your player too. And the best part about this method is that even if your player is red hot, there is no chance that you will get double team, because you don't give defenders a chance to get double team. As you can see, this time I ran a different play, but the result was same, as I just followed the instructions on the screen. And this time I had a different play because I asked for the screen while standing at a different position on the court. So it depends. So as you can see again, I'll again make a play. As you can see, I had the ball, I gave it to one of my teammates, I asked for screen, I was free for a shot, and I made it again. So you just have to keep repeating it, and soon we'll be moving forward towards the glitch part, so your player does not get tired after hitting all these shots. And this is another variation of this play. As you can see, I have a corner specialist badge, so I just asked for a screen, I just played a hesitation move, and I was free for a shot. I'll again show you an example of this shot also. So I had the ball, I asked for the screen, and now I'll play a hesitation move. As you can see, I was free for the shot and I made it. So this is also really good play, but now you have to just save and quit your game once you're towards the end of the second or third quarter and you feel like that your player is getting tired. And you just have to just again load this game that you just saved and keep performing this play, and now you'll notice that your player will be able to make shots with the same efficiency as he was able to make shots at the beginning of this game. So this is a really simple glitch. All you have to do is, when your player starts getting tired, you just have to save and quit the game and load it again. And this is a really simple glitch and it will be patched soon, I know, but still it really works and it helps in getting you points. Like as you can see on my screen right now, my player had 67 points at the end of fourth quarter and I made all these shots by taking jump shots with the help of the method I just showed you, and that's why I got 25,000 shooting badge points. So just keep making that play again and again, and just at the end of the second or third quarter when your player is getting tired, save and quit your game and keep doing that game in and game out, and you will get 20 to 25,000 shooting badge points every game, which will help you in upgrading 2 to 3 badges after every game. So I hope you like this method, and if you have any doubt, write in the comment section. Feel free to write in the comment section. And before going, I just want to again show you this play. So I'll ask for an off-ball screen and this time perform a different play. I'll just follow the instructions on the screen, and as simple as that. So by the end of this game, my player had 73 points. As you can see on your screen, I have 71 points and I'll again make a shot. So yeah, this is the best method for upgrading your shooting badge. So keep performing it on repeat and you will be able to unlock all shooting badges within a day or two. So I hope you liked this video. If you liked it, then please leave a like, and also don't forget to subscribe to PC Helper for regular 2K content. Thank you and have a nice day.